Check out footcointraders.com for all of your ultimate team coins, and be sure to use the code CHEZ at checkout to get yourself an extra discount. Hey guys, how's it going? Chez back again with episode number 7 of the AC Milan career mode here on Xbox One. We had a game yesterday against the main team from Turin, Juventus, and now we're playing the second team from Turin. It's Tivorno, I nearly said then. Torino. I was getting mixed up with Livorno. But Torino are the side we're playing against today, away from home. Of course, they have a very, very good player up top in Alessio Cerci. Definitely going to be an attacking threat. But as you see, we still haven't quite caught up with the rest of the teams around us, games played wise, so where the league doesn't necessarily tell the whole story of our season so far. We're doing okay, although we did of course pick up that defeat yesterday against Juventus. If you missed yesterday's episode, then feel free to check the channel page for it. There will of course be a link in the bottom left hand side of your picture to take you to it. But we got to a fantastic start here, just 4 minutes in, and Alexander Lacazette playing in one of his first starts for the side, playing a bit of a rotation side because it wasn't too long after the Juve game that we had to play this one. Fantastic finish right up into that top right hand side to give us a fantastic start to the game. But Torino came back at us after that. Just a few minutes after we went 1-0 up, it only took a fantastic lunge block there from Christian Zapata to keep them out. But pushing into the 15th, 16th minute now, we're on the attack again, trying to find a second goal if we possibly can. And Lacazette turns beautifully there, and it's only a great save from the goalkeeper Glick or Olic. I'm not too sure whether that was an O or G on his name in the bottom half of the screen. Only a great save from him keeps us out, and Kazuki Honda's going to whip the corner in. Falls to Senad Lulic on the edge of the box. Can't quite find the space first time around. Finds the space second time around when he turns inside. And he is actually right-footed there, Lulic. So that isn't really that bad a shot at all with his weak foot. And it's curling towards the goal. It just isn't quite curling enough to find its way inside that far post and give us a 2-0 lead and a little bit of daylight if possible. So we're trying to find that daylight if we possibly can, because we haven't been the most solid to defend. The most solid defensively in the opening few games, and I really wanted to ensure that we could keep a clean sheet here if we possibly could. And Kaká strikes the post. We think we've got that second goal there, but unfortunately Ignacio Abate is offside, as you can see here. Great effort from Kaká from 30 yards. He really deserved a goal and unfortunate not to get it. But we push into stoppage time at the end of the first half. Senad Lulic breaking down the right hand side, whips the ball in. Kazuki Honda goes up with a header. Unfortunately it goes over the bar, but the referee points to the spot, and you'll be able to see it does hit the defender's arm. And a really weird physics engine there. I had a look at it a second time, took a double take. His arm goes through his face and then bends kind of double jointedly around his back before settling back to a normal position. But Kaká takes the pen, puts it away into the back of the net with absolute style, and we take a 2-0 lead in at half time. And we were looking to build on it in the second half, but not before Torino were going to threaten us at the other end. It's a great cross that comes in, finds their man at the back post, and Basso really should have done better there. Maybe the pressure of Abate coming in on over his shoulders, as you'll be able to see from the replay. Maybe he was got him in the corner of his eye, was worried about getting clattered, but really should have done better with that header. And Torino had a golden chance to get themselves into the lead, but we make a change here. Immobile and Bovo come on for Immobile, I'm not too sure how to pronounce his name, for Torino, who incidentally scored a hat-trick at the weekend in real life, so look out for an informed version of him in Ultimate Team later on this week. But he was definitely going to be a threat for us, but we were trying to threaten ourselves. Senad Lulic into Adel Turetz, brings it down beautifully. Great strike, and we hit the post again for the second time in this episode. Really, really unfortunate for Adel Turetz not to pick up a goal there, but he's involved again, doesn't let that deter him, puts the effort into to win the ball back. Kazuki Honda, great turn onto his favoured left foot, draws the ball across goal and unfortunately doesn't get it into the bottom corner. It isn't quite as accurate as it needed to be to get us into the lead for a third time. Not into the lead, to extend our lead for the third time. We almost end the game in absolute style there. Senad Lulic with the ball over the top. If that had flown into the back of the net, into the top corner, I'd have gone absolutely batshit insane. The technique was beautiful and it was on target to start off with, but just rises and curls away at the last minute, and unfortunately we don't end this game with a showpiece goal. But we do end the game with a 2-0 win and 3 points, and a deserved 3 points, as you can see from the stats. Absolute dominance over Torino here. So we push into the second game of the episode against Udinese, hoping to maintain that run of form now that we've picked up, starting with a stronger side this time. The players have been rested a little bit since that Juventus game, and Stefan Elsharaoui finds himself in the starting lineup for the first time in a couple of games as we take on Udinese at the San Siro. You'll be able to see from the league standings that we're getting a little bit better now up the league. We're up to 7th. We've still got a game in hand on those above us and can go up to 4th into the Europa League spots. Of course, in Italy, It's the top three that qualify for the Champions League, not the top five, as is the case in England. But they're going to get themselves a penalty here for handball, as Montolivo, not really too sure what he's doing, trying to freestyle skill it, kind of duck under the ball, roll it across his arm, etc. You'll see from the penalty, just the weirdest of techniques whatsoever. Just ducks his elbows out, does kind of a chicken dance, and it strikes him on the arm, rolls down his arm before he flicks it up. And unfortunately, Di Natale is going to have the chance to put Udinese 1-0 up from the penalty spot. They've got a very, very good front line with Di Natale and Luis Muriel. And Di Natale compounds our misery there, smashing the ball into the back of the net. And we went 1-0 up early on against Torino in the fourth minute. And it was an equally early goal here that sent us behind against Udinese. But Mario Balotelli picks the ball up on the edge of the box. It's going to do a lovely Ronaldo chop to get inside the player, but just can't quite hold his run. He kind of runs past the ball and has to check back to get it onto his left foot. And unfortunately, that meant that the chance just wasn't of any particular note, and the goalkeeper was easily able to smother it and keep us out. But Balotelli picks up the ball again getting away from the defence, and this time hitting the woodwork. It's the third time we've hit the woodwork in this episode alone, and really unfortunate not to get ourselves back on level terms. And Abate's technique from that volley just wasn't quite good enough to keep it down, and unfortunately we go in at the break 1-0 down. So we're into the second half hoping to get ourselves back into it, but equally early on, as was the case in the first half, they're going to whip the ball in here with Gabriel Silva. Up goes Rami, I think it is, and it's actually DeCilio, the left back, who's going to jump up and handball the ball as it comes in. You see, puts his hand on Di Natale's face, and as Di Natale heads it, it hits DeCilio on the hand, on the fingers. It is another penalty, and unfortunately, Di Natale is going to step up again and going to put it into the back of the net again to give us a 2-0 deficit to try and get back in this game. And Di Natale, obviously a consummate professional and someone that's been at the top of his game for year upon year for Udinese. But Balotelli, another nice Ronaldo chop inside. Decent finesse shot. Unfortunately, the goalkeeper's down well at his near post to keep us out. We're into the 85th minute now, so it's all or nothing as we head towards the end of the game. Senad Lulic whips the ball in. Up goes Adil Rami. Can't get the header on target. Loses it. Abate picks the ball up, goes for the smash, and it's straight down the goalkeeper's throat. He's easily able to catch it, and unfortunately, we pick up another defeat. We just don't seem to be playing very well against teams that play in black and white vertical stripes. Obviously, losing the game against Juventus yesterday, and now against Udinese today. And unfortunately, considering we had that game against Udinese not too long after the Torino game, we actually had to rotate the side again in a very, very tough game away at Chelsea in the Champions League. You'll be able to see from the table that pops up on your screen in just a minute. We do sit top of the table, so it is a game that we don't necessarily have to win, as we sit 3 points clear after a win over Olympiacos and Zenit St. Petersburg. But it is a game that would be nice to win if we possibly could. And we're going to catch them on a counter-attack in the early stages. Adil Turabt linking up very, very well with Alexander Lacazette. Going to play the ball over the top. JT misses the flight of the ball. Lacazette's in, goes for that poacher's finish, but unfortunately Petr is on form to keep us out. And after an early goal in the opening two games, there isn't an early goal in this one. But Kaká's going to pick the ball up from the throw-in, throw it out towards Nigel de Jong. He's going to pick it ball up off a loose touch from Willian, play the ball about Kevin Constant into Abu Diaby, twisting and turning on the edge of the box, finds Ignacio Abate. Great strike. It's well blocked by the defender, though. It's going to go out for a corner, and we're going to have another chance to get ourselves in front if we possibly can. Lulic on the corner again, whipping it in. Up goes Alexander Lacazette, and of all the players on the pitch you expect to win a header in a busy box set against three Chelsea defenders, it wasn't 5'9" Alexander Lacazette. But nonetheless, he is the man that rises and puts us in the lead early on in this game. So we do have a third early goal, and Adil Turabt comes even closer just a few minutes later. Another deflected shot on the half hour to unfortunately take the ball wide. We get another corner. We scored from the first corner. Can we score from this one? Play it short this time to Nigel de Jong. He's going to look for a man on the edge of the box. It's Abu Diaby, formerly of Arsenal, of course. But Petr is on hand to be able to make a very, very good save. And unfortunately, we stay at 1-0. But the pressure isn't done for the first half. Lacazette's in behind again. And this time, Petr makes two fantastic saves. He did actually get a touch to that to push it onto the post before it rebounded out. And unfortunately, we still have to wait for a second goal. But a lovely ball over the top towards Kaká. Here he's in behind, holds off Azpilicueta beautifully. Great strike across goal. And again, Petr makes another good save. Diving save down to his left-hand side to keep us out. We really are putting the pressure on Chelsea here. And I was particularly disappointed with the way that they really weren't as good as I expected them to be. To be completely honest, I really was nervous going into this game. Away at Stamford Bridge, at Stamford Bridge, expecting them to be all over me, to be completely honest, and they really weren't. We were all over them. Really surprising to have this sort of dominance away at Chelsea. There's the sort of side that is normally particularly strong at home, especially under José Mourinho. But Abu Diaby finds Alexander Lacazette, and it's another great save from Petr Cech. OP, as he makes another great save. But we made a change, Kazuki Honda coming on for Adel Taarabt, and be able to see in just a second why I made that change. Because we pick up a free kick in very, very dangerous territory. 30 yards out, Honda has the goal. Has the goal, has the free kick that ends in a goal on his left foot, right into that top corner. Beautiful free kick to give us a 2-0 lead and win. We'll see a couple of replays of that goal from Koizuki Honda there. He is a free kick specialist. He's not done much for me, to be completely honest, in these opening few games in this career mode, and I am contemplating moving him on either in the summer or at the end of the season. But if he can still, make the difference for the team when needed at times like that, not necessarily as frequently as I might like, but still, he did make the difference there and put the game to bed to give us all 3 points. We take 3 wins from 3 in the Champions League now. We do sit clear at the top of the Champions League table, and we're up, or down rather, to a 9th in the league, but still with a game in hand, and can go up to 6th should we win that game in hand. So European spots aren't too far out of reach now. It's just a case of winning our games in hand, which actually is against Hellas Verona in just a couple of days' time. But that will be in tomorrow's episode. Of course, today's Tuesday, so there will be a My Player episode tonight at 9 o'clock in your sub boxes. I know the Manchester Derby's tonight as well, so you may be watching that a little bit later than 9 o'clock. So do feel free to check your sub boxes for it. If you aren't subscribed and you don't want to miss out on any of the content coming from this channel, then hit that subscribe button. There's a link in the description and an annotation on screen over that little YouTube emblem there. And if you missed the previous episode in this series yesterday, then feel free to click the annotation on the right hand side to take you to that video, and feel free to follow me on Twitter as well at Chesnoy Gaming to keep up to date with everything that goes on with me and my YouTube channel. But that's all for today, guys. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you tonight with the My Player episode, and tomorrow with more AC Milan.